Well, it's good to get to do a devotion again and read God's Word to you, because God's Word is a lamp unto our feet, a light unto our pathway, and it's such an encouragement to read His Word and know that since we're God's children that we can stand on His Word. He is faithful to keep His Word. And I was praying about this devotion and trying to find the right topic, the right subject, right scriptures, and woke up one morning and I had to get up quick. I thought, oh, I've got to write this down. I know this is from the Lord, so I take it for myself, and I know it's for you too. I felt God deal with me that someone's going to be listening to this that's been praying about something. So I titled it, God is Working. And I want to remind you that God's working behind the scenes. You've been praying about something, and you're not seeing those prayers answered yet. But let me tell you, God is working behind the scenes in your situation. We know that God is working to get your prayer answered. I want to read from Isaiah 59, and you've heard this scripture no doubt many times, but let me remind you what Isaiah said here in the first verse of the 59th chapter. Behold, the Lord's hand is not shortened that it cannot save, neither His ear heavy that it cannot hear. We know that God is hearing your prayer today. You have prayed about this, and God has heard your faithful prayer. And so don't give up praying. Don't lose your faith in what God is doing behind the scenes that you cannot see. And so many times after a sinner has been prayed for many years, sometimes they'll come and get saved, and they'll start telling thing after thing that had happened in their life, where God was dealing and moving. And it's so encouraging when you see the answer to your prayers. So just think of the end result of your prayer and your faith to God. I want to read also another scripture in 1 John 5:14. And this is the confidence that we have in Him, that if we ask anything according to His will, He heareth us. And we know it's God's will to save folks. We know it's His will to meet their every need if they'll trust in Him. And it's His will for them to come to heaven where He is. And that's why He sent His Son, that we could all be saved. And it's not His will that any should perish. I want to read also in Psalms 27:14. It says, wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and He shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. And after we pray these prayers time and time again, sometimes the enemy would like to come at us and say, well, it's not doing any good. You prayed for this many days, this many maybe months, this many years. But I'm telling you, when you pray, I promise you, God hears the prayer of His children and is going to be moving in that situation. Keep praying on. Don't get weary in well-doing, because you're going to reap if you faint not. So let's don't faint in our praying. Just keep looking to the Lord. I want to read also in Acts, the 10th chapter. And this was a praying man, and we're going to see a little bit what happened for a praying man, a devout praying man. It says, Acts, the 10th chapter. I'll just go ahead and do the second verse for the sake of time. He said Cornelius was a devout man and one that feared God with all of his house, which gave much alms to the people and prayed to God always. He saw in a vision, evidently about the 9th hour of the day, an angel of God coming into him and saying unto him, Cornelius. And when he looked on him, he was afraid and said, what is it, Lord? And he said unto him, thy prayers and thine alms are come up for a memorial before God. And the angel told Cornelius, said, and now send you men to Joppa and call for one Simon, whose surname is Peter. And so Cornelius really didn't know what was fixing to happen. He had prayed and he'd been faithful. God had plans behind the scenes for Cornelius and his house. His house was fixing to have revival. So Brother Peter came and was talking to him, preaching to him. And it said in verse 44 of the 10th chapter, while Peter yet spake these words, the Holy Ghost fell on all of them which heard the word. And I'm telling you, a Holy Ghost revival broke out there in Brother Cornelius's house. And behind the scenes, God was preparing a great revival for that brother and his household and the friends he brought in. That showed he was a man of faith, that he was believing that God had mighty things in store and greater things he was believing for. Even though Cornelius was a Gentile, he was a Roman centurion of the Italian band, the Bible says there. And you have your prayer time. You have your time of studying God's Word, and you love going to God's house. Even in a time like this, when, you know, things is, we have to do a little different than what we had been because, you know, this is what's going around. But you're faithful to do what you can to build up the kingdom of God. God sees your faithfulness, and He's working behind the scenes for you, for your church, for your family, for your friends. And I'm telling you, I really feel the Holy Ghost to tell you, God's going to send revival to your community, to your church, to your family. Those lost loved ones you've been praying for, and it just looks like maybe there's not anything happening. Let me tell you, God is working on them loved ones, and He's getting their attention. And so be encouraged today to just keep on praying. The effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man or woman availeth much. And your prayers has come before the Lord, and He's hearing your prayers. Be encouraged and just be faithful, and God's going to say, well done, thy good and faithful servant, in the near future. God bless you. We love you.